What's happening, family? It's your man, the Czar. Welcome to Strategy Session Volume 5. Prerequisite for this show is Strategy Session Volume 4, Shooting Slider Adjustments. If you haven't checked that out and you get lost or not understanding what we're talking about here, go back and check that out. First off, when you're talking video game basketball, there are many myths. Like if I'm a great shooter and I'm open, I release at the top of my jump, I should never miss. You know, cause NBA players don't miss open shots. Or if I'm all over a guy contesting, that should be a miss every time. They never hit contested shots in the NBA. Absolutes like this have no place in any attempt to replicate the NBA game. That's not reality. Basketball is a game of percentages, because it is possible to both make and miss good and bad shots. With that fact established, let's talk briefly about the shot indicators available and what they can and cannot tell you. If you go into Options, My NBA and Presentation and scroll down, you'll see two shot feedback options, shot timing and shot quality. We'll look at shot timing first. The shot timing can be early, on time, or late. If early, you will see the circle appear in red here. When the shot is on time, you'll see the circle appear here in green. Finally, if your shot is late, you'll see it appear here in red. The window for a perfect release shrinks as you move up in difficulty, and the penalty for a miss gets more and more severe as you move up. Next, let's look at shot quality. Shot quality is not a guarantee or promise that a shot will fall. It merely informs you if that shot you took was of high or low quality. As I move outside of Dirk's range, you can see it inform me that I'm taking lower quality shots. If I turn back on shot timing feedback, you can see that the timing of my release also affects my shot quality rating. Now, if we get Chandler out here shooting from the same area, we notice something different. As long as his release is good, he is able to get a good shot quality with a perfect release as he's wide open. Watch how severe his penalty is, however, with bad timing on his release. Now, once we move well outside his range, thankfully his release makes no difference. So there is a clear separation between good shooters and bad shooters with respect to timing windows. So the indicators do not promise any particular shot will be made or missed. They tell you whether you gave yourself the best opportunity to have a shot go in. Did you get the right shooter in the right place with the right release? One thing that is confusing for gamers new to 2K is seeing shot quality with a D or F in an early or late release and see the ball still go in the basket. As we examine 2K's system in depth, it starts to make a little more sense. Let's take Dirk into practice mode. If you hit the back button, you'll bring up a player's hot zones. Red spaces are his hot zones, blue are his cold zones, and the gray are neutral. With Dirk, who has a 99 mid-range rating, when I shoot 10 perfect release shots from this distance in his neutral zone, Dirk will hit between 7 or 8 out of every 10 shots. When I move him to his hot zones from the same distance, he's going to hit 8 or 9 out of every 10 shots. When I take Jason Kidd into practice mode, the same shots from the same range in his neutral zone, he averaged 7 out of 10. In his cold zone, he hit a frigid 4 out of 10. So again, we see that even with cold zones, it is apparent that the worse the shooter, the stiffer the penalty. Now that is with a perfect release. Let's see what happens when you have a bad release. Ouch! Dirk goes 4 for 10 in his neutral zone with an early release. And not much better, only 5 of 10 out of his hot zone with an early release. With Kid in his neutral zone with an early release, I hit 1 out of 10. And in the cold zone with Kid, I missed 20 straight shots. So you can see the system makes sense. Good shooters and better players have more leniency with missed shots and more reward with good ones. Hot and cold zones matter, and they matter the most to bad shooters. Now we're finally ready to talk about defense. Until that time, it's your man the Czar reminding you, don't play video games, play basketball.